Rejoice, for death has lost its power. Rejoice, now the victory is ours.
Rejoice. It's an interesting word because when we think about the world around us, there's not a lot to rejoice about. And the truth is, with all the news stories and cycles and headlines and all of this stuff, there's a lot of bad news in the world. And so when you say the word rejoice, it sounds like, once again, Christians are out of touch with reality, because what is there to rejoice about? But the truth is, the gospel reframes the story of the world. The gospel tells us that, yes, this world is fallen, and yes, this world is broken, but God has come into his own world. Jesus stepped into it. And because Jesus came into our world, he carried upon himself all of the brokenness of our world. On the cross, the gospel says, Jesus took on himself the weight of evil, the weight of our sin, the full weight of our brokenness, and he died on that cross to carry it. But when God raised Jesus from the dead, something changed. This was God's great victory over all that is sick and wrong and broken in the world. This is God's way of saying, listen, death will not be the last word. Sorrow will not be the end. Brokenness is not the way this story is told. No, God tells the story of the world as a story of redemption, as a story of restoration. When God raised Jesus from the dead, what he was saying is this: my plan for this world is to put it all back together. As Christians, what we believe about Easter, what we believe about resurrection, is that God has brought this future forward into the present. Already, right now, we're beginning to see and taste and experience new creation. That's something worth rejoicing about. When you look at all the hymns that the church has sung and the Easter choruses and songs about resurrection, there's so much hope and there's so much joy, not as a way of denying the reality of the world, but as a way of giving witness to a greater reality, a deeper truth, that our God is at work within this world to redeem it. He's victorious over death, over sin, over evil. And because we believe that, we rejoice.